This video demonstrates how to create a multi-level facility with lifts and establish the movement of transporters across the levels. Let's follow an AGV that fetches items stored on the first floor and moves them to workstations located on the ground floor. We'll create the same model by adding the ground floor, AGV network, and a lift to a simple model of a single floor facility. Expand the Levels widget menu at the bottom of the graphical editor. As you can see, the model currently comprises two levels, Navigation and First Floor. The Navigation level contains a custom navigation bar. This approach reduces the density of active elements on the graphical editor when we switch to a different level, since the elements that belong to one level are inaccessible on other levels. Let's switch to the First Floor level. You can see that the inactive level becomes dimmed. We can see its general outline, but it doesn't obstruct our view of the currently active level. The Levels menu allows you also to make the non-active levels completely invisible or always visible. This level contains the space markup elements that define the first floor of our modeled facility. Here we may find the pallet racks with material items and the AGV home station. To understand how to position the new level, let's look up the Z-coordinate of the first floor level. Navigate to the Projects view, expand the Main element, and then expand the Presentation group. Click the First Floor level in the Model tree and navigate to its properties. By default, the first floor level's Z-coordinate is set to 0. Now we'll add the ground floor to our facility. Click the Create a New Level control to add a level to the model. Here we'll place the workstations and create a new network for AGV movement. Navigate to the level's properties and change the default name to Ground Floor. We want the new floor to be below the current floor and to have a ceiling height of 5 meters. The scale of our model is 20 pixels per meter, therefore the Z-coordinate of the ground floor level must be set to negative 100. Let's visualize the floor surface of the ground floor area. Drag the rectangle element from the presentation palette and resize it according to the dimension of the first floor area. Navigate to the properties of the rectangle. Expand the Position and Size section. Set Z to -1 and its Z height to 1. Expand the Appearance section of the rectangle's properties and set the fill color to floral white. Lock the rectangle. It's time to add the walls. In this model, the walls are used mainly to define the visual space of the facility. Draw the wall along the perimeter of the ground floor area. Remember to leave a wall opening for the lift doors. We'll also add two rectangular walls at the corners of the ground floor area. When done, press and hold the Control key and click All Walls for multiple selection. Now, change the color of the selected walls. We'll also increase transparency to facilitate visibility of the internal layout in 3D animation. Change the height of the selected walls. Add three more wall segments to divide the ground floor into working areas for different manufacturing machines that we'll add later. Change color of these wall segments to match the previously drawn walls. And set their Z height to 100. Now, let's define the target points where the AGV will deliver the items to. Drag the Point Node element from the Space Markup palette and place it in the desired location. Name the node Workstation. Press and hold the Control key and drag the node to copy it. Create 5 copies of the node and distribute them across the ground floor of our facility. Next, we should connect these nodes with paths to create a network where the AGV will navigate. Double-click the Path element in the Space Markup palette to enter the drawing mode. Click the border of the node where you want to start the path and draw the segment. Finish drawing with a double-click at the entrance to the ground floor. Now, connect the other nodes to the first path in the same manner. let's resize the intersection nodes for better visibility. Select the node and drag the handle outwards. Repeat this for all three nodes. Finally, we should tell the AGV where to deliver the items. Select the destination nodes. Right-click the selection and create a collection that will contain all these elements. Name the collection Workstations. Select the Move by Transporter block and navigate to its properties. Switch the Node parameter to the Dynamic Value Editor. This mode allows us to specify more than one node as the possible destination. In the Node field, type Random from Workstations. This function selects a random destination node from the collection of nodes. There, the network is ready. Let's create a lift. We will add a lift element to each floor to model lift landings and connect them to each other through the element's properties. Switch to the first floor level. Drag the lift element from the space markup palette to the graphical editor and place it at the wall opening on this floor. Use the handles to make the lift fit the wall opening. Select the path leading to the entrance and connect it to the lift port. When properly connected, the port is highlighted in green. Select the lift and navigate to its properties. Name this lift landing First Floor Lift. Select the Main Landing option to make this element define parameters of lift movement. Now, expand the Appearance section and set the fill color. Switch to the ground floor level and in the same manner create another lift landing. Name it Ground Floor Lift. In its properties, set the floor elevation to -5. To connect the two lift elements, set the Refers to Main Landing parameter to First Floor Lift. Change the landing color. Now let's add 3D objects that will represent the manufacturing stations, to which the AGV will transport the items. Navigate to the 3D Objects palette. Expand the CNC Machines section and drag the CNC Grinder 1 State 2 to the graphical editor. Resize the object to match the agent's scale. Adjust its position. In the same manner, add two copies of CNC Grinder 2 State 2 object and three copies of CNC Lathe Machine 5 State 2 object. Now we're ready to run the model and see how it works. Thanks for watching. We hope this video will help you level up your models. Put your thumbs up, and we'll get back with more AnyLogic how-to videos.